Hey guys, Rob Baldwin here, IMAX Productions, 10 Minute Design. Hopefully everyone here has had a chance to go see Rogue One. If not, go see it. It's awesome. A great new addition to the Star Wars franchise. Just an all-out good movie. So I figured I'd do some sort of Photoshop tutorial to play into, you know, the whole Rogue One craze that's going on right now. So here's one of the posters that was released for Rogue One. So we've got the guys running on the beach here, and a fight going on, and we got the nice Death Star in the background. So I figured what we're going to do, I'm going to show you how you can take the Death Star and put it into the background, into the horizon of any photo that you would take. So take a nice family photo on the beach or something, throw the Death Star in there, just make it really cool. Okay, so let's get started right away. You're going to need two things for this. You're going to need a photo that has a nice wide sky horizon. Okay, so I want to see lots of sky because that's where we're going to put the Death Star. And then secondly, we need a Death Star. Okay, so here's the photo I'm going to work with right here. This is my dog here at our cottage. And then we want a Death Star photo. So this is a good one. I just Googled Death Star. You're going to find hundreds of photos. Make sure it's a fairly high quality, so fairly high res. Okay, so simply right-click, copy image. We're going to come into Photoshop here, and we're going to new document, okay, and simply paste our Death Star in there. Here, now I don't have enough sky, so I'm going to do a quick adjustment to my photo to make sure we have enough sky going on. So I want to just double-click on the background here, hit okay. That's just going to make it it's a layer as opposed to a background image. Now I can just drag my photo down. I want to keep the dog in there, so don't go too far down. And then just get a nice rectangular marquee tool and select the sky as close as you can to the trees in the background there. And then we're going to hit Command or Control T for transform and simply whoop, and yeah, just stretch it out to fit. So now we have a nice wide sky, skyline horizon that we can put our Death Star into. All right, let's go back to our image here. Simple. We're just going to grab the magic wand tool. Make sure you have a tolerance of about 20 because if you're at 2, it might not select all the white background. So 20-ish should select everything. And yeah, perfect. Hit delete. Now we've got just the Death Star layer. So Command Control A to select everything. Command Control C, copy, and then we're going to paste it into our image. Obviously it's tiny, so we're going to scale it up. Free transform, Command Control T. Okay, we're gonna place it about here. Let's look at our source material here. It's about what we wanna do. We wanna kind of match this. Now, looking at this photo, let's kind of examine the Death Star in this photo here. Obviously, we wanna try to match ours to fit this, okay? So, very simply, we've got, if you look at the shadowing, nothing gets darker than the sky. There's not much that you look in here. I'm not seeing any darker blues than the sky. First of all, it's not gray. It matches the sky tone. So that's the first thing we're going to do is desaturate. Okay. But see the sky tones here? They're about the same. Nothing is darker. So we want to remove any shadows that's darker. We do have the light tones. So that's important to know. We've got all the little lights here and the lighter tones here. And then lastly, it kind of fades to the horizon. So right here at the bottom horizon, we don't see any Death Star. A little bit here, but it does fade. And then we can always, and then right in the corner here. So we're gonna add kind of a diagonal fade across, and then we wanna add a fade at the horizon. Okay, so let's go do that. So let's place it about where I wanna place it. So first thing we wanna do, let's just hide that layer for now. Select our background. We wanna just chop out the horizon. So we're gonna grab the magnetic lasso tool, come down here and just loosely select the horizon. We're gonna go up and around and back here. Now we kind of chopped the corners there, so just grab the lasso tool. If you hold down shift, see a little plus, you're gonna add to it. We're just gonna grab that and grab this side. And then what we're gonna do is simply make a folder, make a group. So group one here, and with still this selected, we're gonna hit the mask tool. So that's gonna create a mask. Everything that's in that group is only gonna appear within that mask. Now, I know we loosely selected, you could go in and, you know, get every single tree here. I don't think that's necessary, especially since we did check our source material in the Rogue One poster, and the Death Star does fade to the horizon, so we don't we're not going to worry too much about that. Okay, now let's grab the Death Star. Let's throw him in that folder. And then he is now behind the horizon. Perfect. Okay, first things first, desaturate. So we're going to come up here, Image, Adjustments, Desaturate. So now it still looks gray, but we removed all color, essentially. Now back up to Image Adjustments, we're going to go to Hue and Saturation. Now what we want to do is Colorize, and we're going to match the blue as best you can. It doesn't have to be perfect. Okay, we're now going to drop the opacity. Probably around here is good. 35%. So I want to see those, you know, the lines here. I want to look, because those technically, those clouds and stuff are technically in front of the Death Star. The Death Star is all the way in space. It is in front. So we can play with the opacity later, but for now, that's looking good. Okay, like we mentioned, we don't want anything darker than the sky tones. So what we want to do, go up here, Adjustment Levels, Curves. And I'm going to move the black up until we've eliminated those darker tones. And we want the lighter tones are quite heavy, so we can actually bring those up as long as they're straight. But so you're gonna play with that until it's somewhere where you like it. Okay, looking good. We're now gonna add a mask to it. So hit down here, mask. We're gonna grab our gradient tool, make sure it's just black to white, and we're gonna give it that fade that it had. There we go. Let's do it one more time. That looks pretty good. And of course, the last, it did fade down by the horizon. So with the mask layer still selected, we're going to grab a brush. We want it fairly high, so that's good. We want it zero hardness. I want it completely feathered. And then opacity fairly low, and we're simply going to mass feather out some of that. Okay, I think it's looking pretty good, maybe. And then you can always play with this, with the mask, with the brushes. Okay, remember the rules of Photoshop masks, anything that is black gets removed, is transparent. Anything that is white shows through the layer. So you can use the brushes using black and white on the mask, just brush in white where you want your photo to bleed through, brush black where you want the photo to be invisible and see the background layer. Okay, so play with that and there we go. Okay, so very simple to do these kind of fun tutorials, these fun things where you just throw something into the background and make it really cool like that, okay? So hope you enjoy that tutorial, guys. Please check out other tutorials. Check out these, we have a few other Star Wars inspired tutorials. Check those out, please. And don't forget, follow me on all social media. I'm there. Don't forget to subscribe and check out the website. We will see you next time. Cheers.